It'll be New Zealand to get us underway, running right to left, all in black. Down to Zaydar for France. Early possession, but look at the counter ruck early from Scott Curry and Sam Dixon. They do love to flood the breakdown, immediately get a reward.
It's an area I think they really took it a step, and they're going to go quick.
Weber in his 50th tournament on the series. Amanaki Nicole with the start for the All Black Sevens, back with this team after a long time away. And here's Scott Curry. Runs it straight and true. Brady Rush there. Weber. Roko Lisoa. Nicole's got Cody Vai out on the right wing, but he's going to take the responsibility to get good go forward. He does exactly that. Quick reload as well. Rush and Dixon, who went through 100 tries all time yesterday. Roko Lisoa, they got to watch him. He's so dangerous. Here's Nicole, lively early. Long left to right ball. Vai does well to take it high. 6 metres out, New Zealand. Nicole. Curry. Really good width and ball movement from New Zealand. Hitch kick from Brady Rush. Good tackle from Zaydar. Dixon has it inside to Curry. Really good defence this from France. It has to be, because New Zealand are playing keep ball really well. Now the opportunity to spin it again. Weber, he's got Vai out wide. Takes it and scores.
Well, what a sequence of play from New Zealand. Vai is going to get the try, but right from the kickoff, New Zealand applying pressure physically to get the turnover. Wave after wave after wave. The patience was fantastic. The passes were good, and Cody Vai gets it started for the All Black Sevens.
Yeah, that's his third of the weekend. Cody Vai. And Roko Lisoa with the conversion attempt. Won't get the extra two. Yes, he will. Makes it. Thought it was going to slide by. They get the maximum. 7-0 New Zealand lead France.
And I actually like that by referee Tavita Rokovarini. It was a high shot or shoulder tackle by the French captain Riva as Vai put it down, but he said nothing wrong with that. Let's keep going. Good decision. Seven players on the field.
We're back underway.
Pass the ball. Hands pass the ball first. Leave it seven. Wait.
France will have possession here. Walk Jordan away. Seffo out there seven. Taking the restart.
Just walk
in
away.
The no-numbered shirt.
Good.
Well, this is what the French needed, just to get the ball and just reset there. They've had to do a lot of tackling for the first minute and a half. And that set while New Zealand had the ball, so they go. They're going to line out, set piece.
Correction, Vadi and Pasquet, there he is. He's the player with the no number. So a good opportunity here for Stephen Perez and France inside New Zealand territory to hit back after conceding the first try here. And they bring it down well. Riva in midfield, two. Riva now again. He's got Jefferson Lee Joseph with him. Plenty of pace, Joseph. Nicole working the steal, can't get it. Zaydar across now to Red Badge, flicks it over the shoulder to Jordan Seffo, trying to get away from Weber. Weber, New Zealand's leading tackler this weekend. Zaydar comes away with it again. Red Badge, Pasquet, they're in business here, France, if they can shift it. Joseph, little in and away, and they will score. Nicely done from France. They're within two.
Very professional, wasn't it? After they got the penalty just outside their own 22, they went to the line out. It was good execution there. And the skipper gives the last pass, pulling Riva. Defense couldn't get across after multiple phases. A fantastic reply by Jefferson Lee Joseph.
Conversion attempt won't make it, so it'll remain 2 points the difference. Good try from France, unbeaten at this tournament.
Yeah, they've got a great balance about them, don't they, this weekend, this French outfit. Just feel this one's going to come down to one moment for sure. Both teams playing very well.
Yeah, they've got good muscle memory against New Zealand as well. Ended a 10-game losing stretch against the All Black Sevens in Perth last time out. It was a big win as well. 33-17 that finished. Although that restart hasn't gone the 10, so New Zealand will have the option on halfway.
And this is where they are so dangerous, these tap kicks. A lot of teams have gone for the scrum, and this is what they're going to do here in New Zealand as well. And I like the way coaches have really used this as a launch pad and have been very inventive about how they use their players and their teams.
Yeah. And same for you. I need you to go straight. Okay? Don't stand up. Let's go.
Tex Rocco-Vedeni, his 150th event as a referee with some clear instructions at the scrum here.
Bind! Set! Yeah, keep it
so
that
approaching
way.
The final
number
minute of the first half of this Men's Cup
keep
semi-final. Rocco Lasoa gets it away to Rush. Vai again. He's all energy, Cody Vai. He's had to be too. No Leroy Carter please. This weekend for the All Black Sevens. He's been a real energizer for them. They come away with it with the penalty decision. A big old dummy from Rocco Lasoa. And he burst through the tackle. And he will score. Right between the posts for New Zealand. The Rocket Man showing up again when it's needed most.
Especially in the playmaking role, he really has taken charge and he's found his confidence, that's for sure. Rocco Lasoa.
I didn't see that one.
See that? No way he was going to pass that. He even fakes the cameraman out. He gets the defender and wiggles him off. And Aquila Rocco Lasoa just knifes through.
No, he's been absolutely outstanding, nominated for Player of the Year last season. Aquila Rocco Lasoa came in. 83 tries all time. He's added another 5 this weekend already and an extra couple of points also. We'll have a restart here. There you go, series points. Look how tight that is. Marcus Moneta on top. He doesn't kick goals, remember. Zaidar wins the restart for France. Here's Varian Pasquet.
Bounce from black.
Opportunity here for the team in blue to close the gap just before the break. Capilla there. Thinks about the offload out the back. There it is now to Pasquet. Bit of momentum here for France. Reeves there supporting. Rush. Slightly awkward tackle. Puts him on the floor. There's Rebage to Perez. Little stop-go to Joseph. He's got Seffol to his left. Got to be careful not to get isolated. Gets up, goes again. No knock-on. Sefo's there just in time. Has that gone forward off Weber? They get a penalty anyway. Perez goes quick. Into New Zealand territory now. Pauline Riva. Almost through for France. Picks it up off the deck. Rabage holds onto it. Still alive for France.
No.
They've got another decision here. And they go quickly. If they can put it through their hands, they should have another score. Seffol, he'll just burst through and score. Jordan Seffol. His 6th try in Vancouver this weekend. 4 points the difference.
Well, three penalties on the trot. Ill discipline from New Zealand, allowing France to get some momentum. And it just feels like a chess match, doesn't it, at the moment? Both teams having answers to questions.
Yeah, high quality game of rugby sevens. Just those decisions going against New Zealand, one after the other, allowed France to get the momentum and they get the conversion as well.
Conversion is good.
So we will go to halftime with just 2 points separating New Zealand and France in the Cup semi-final. And France contemplating a change perhaps. You can see number 25 on the near touchline there, Antoine Dupont. There he is, preparing to make an entrance. Got him through to this Cup semi-final, Dupont, with a match winner in the quarter last night. Here's Cody Vai again for New Zealand, though. Try score in the first half. Pasquet and Riva put him on the floor. 2 tries apiece, just 1 conversion separating these 2 sides at the moment. There's Weber. Nicole cuts inside. Manaki Nicole looks full of energy. Here's Vai again. If he can shift it, he's got Brady Rush over to his left. Ball in one hand, goes to deck. They reload quick. Nicole again, here's Curry. Big, big team out there for New Zealand. Plenty of size, and Weber gets chopped
down.
Did
you lost it, Pancho? Okay, thank you.
Here's Rush. puts a bit of pace on the ball to Rocalesso. He's already made one line break try in this match. No look pass to Vai from Rush.
Advantage over.
New Zealand did have an advantage. It's over now. You heard the referee. Here's Weber. Offloads to Curry. Loads and loads of possession and passes for New Zealand here. Here's Rokolisso. He sees a gap and he's through. Look at him go. You open the door ever so slightly and Rokolisso will just burst through it all day long.
Aquila Rokolisso with the wiggle in the middle. We can see there, freezes the defender, gets caught flat-footed. But it's the first one, two, three steps off the mark that gets him through the hole. Switches the ball for the defender if he needs it. Has a look around, he doesn't need anyone. Individual brilliance from the number four.
How often do we see it? Rokolisso making the difference for New Zealand. Converts his own try, 21-12. And there you go. He's on top of the series points now. Aquila Rokolisso.
And guess who has come in to equal that up? The superstar. There he is, Dupont.
Can Antoine Dupont make the difference for France here? It's gone over everybody's head. That it'll actually be a New Zealand throw to the line-out. Touch the French hand. They'll have to do more defending here.
Yeah, in the body language at the moment for the French. Not that good. They need to compete at this line-out, that's for sure. First time I've really been under maximum pressure. Both teams, a competition in the air.
Four subs.
Just the fingertips.
Time is off. Yeah.
Of Esteban Capilla there as he contested with Curry. Unlucky break. Yeah, there's plenty of love. For that man, Antoine Dupont, but he's got defense at the moment. Weber with a nice change of direction. Sofia Nunganofo. Here goes Scott Curry thundering towards the try line. And there's number four for New Zealand. Oh, they're bringing their best stuff in Vancouver on finals day.
And this is something they would have had exactly for this situation. They go out to the middle of the park. Joe Weber wraps around that speed. They call out two defenders. They got the overlap and Scott Curry will finish.
His 128th try in his stellar career. First of the weekend, what a time to do it. 26-12, make it 28. Big opening to the second period for New Zealand.
It's been a very professional and concise effort here from New Zealand, putting themselves in the positions and then executing.
Well, France need the ball. They haven't had it in the second half. They go the same direction off the restart, New Zealand. This time, Capilla has time to bring it down. There is Antoine Dupont at scrum half. Joseph. Back to Dupont. Can he conjure something up for France? Runs at the line, holds on, dishes it indoors to Fournier. He got a hat-trick, Fournier, against New Zealand when they beat them in Perth a few weeks ago. Here's Joseph again. 28-12 down, 3 minutes to go. France needs some points. They've got an advantage.
High.
Rabage taps and goes quickly. He's got Antoine Dupont with him. Gives it to Dupont. Lovely little step in and away. Antoine Dupont, he's got loads of support out right, and Reva can't hold on. He said it went backwards, sir. But knock on is the call, and that's a massive opportunity missed for the team in blue.
That's what he can do. The classy Dupont. Everyone was asking, can he make the switch? Subs. Oh, yeah, I think he's answered that for sure.
Number six,
with Reba. Good. I think this went back. This is harsh. Goes through the hands. Unlucky.
It almost feel like drop ball rules at times in sevens, doesn't it? You get nailed if you drop it, even if it goes backwards. He's going to come off the field as well, Reba, it looks like, on the near side. Those two actually have a really good connection too, because they used to play together at the Oach Club as juniors, Reva and Antoine Dupont.
Crouch.
France need a scrum here. Crouch. Need to put some pressure on.
Bind.
Cook Savage to feed
Sit.
It. Just outside the New Zealand 22. 2:20 to go, 28-12 on the board. Vai. Really good footwork again from Cody Vai, wearing number 25 on February 25th on his 20th birthday. Clark outside the 22, penalty New Zealand.
New Zealand will slow this right down, that's for sure. No need to rush now, two score lead. And that's this key. And they've managed this game, that's for sure. They've been physical at the breakdown, they've dominated that area, and like you said, Rupert Francis haven't had enough possession to do anything.
Sapaia Cook-Savage here, he's been a standout for New Zealand, for Waikato rather, in the New Zealand National Provincial Championship. He's trying to G him up, Antoine, isn't he? The fans have loved seeing him here this weekend. That was the smile after the drop from his good buddy Reva.
Let's go quicker. Okay.
A wry smile. 1:20 to go now. New Zealand in control, it seems, of this cup semi-final. Very professional performance so far. Dixon wins it. They were contesting France, and they have to. They've got to try and get the ball back somehow. Oh, lovely wraparound. And a good tackle on Finianga Nofo. DuPont involved, but New Zealand still have it. They get it away so quickly from the breakdown. Over the top to Cody Vai. Playing with six here, New Zealand, because Finianga Nofo is slow to get back in the attacking line. There he is, number 33. Carried forward by Xavier Tito Harris. Cook-Savage now across to Shea Clark. Clark gets the hands free to Cook-Savage. DuPont, though, holds onto him, and he rips the ball away. Brilliantly in contact, Antoine DuPont. Great strength from the French master. And now here comes Andy Timo. He gets the ball away, and France are going to get a try through Rabage. The clock's against them here, but they will go under the bar. There will be a restart.
Oh, he's just an influence, isn't he? DuPont, we keep singing his praises, but look at him, he chased across. That's a one-on-one strip, the strength of the man. Unbelievable. And from that, this is the result. Take it forward, you got the numbers. New Zealand have committed to their ruck. And Rabage will finish from deep.
Rayan Rabage from the Toulon club on the Côte d'Azur. Got the ball from the Parisian Timo. At 28-19.
Time off.
Still a two-score game. New Zealand should be through here.
Oh, it's just a shame for the French outfit. They just didn't have enough opportunities with ball in hand.
Is there an argument that maybe DuPont should have started the game? I mean, the interventions he's made in this game since coming on have been absolutely first class. Well, that ball's over the sideline. There is a penalty here, though. France.
You're on the ground. Yeah.
We're in added seconds here, but France can keep going.
I'm with you. He's such an influence, DuPont. You've got to ask the question, is that good?
Your mark's inside, Antoine.
I mean, it's his first weekend of rugby sevens. He looks completely at home. If that connection with Reva had worked out, it could have been a different story here. They shoot out of the line and try to grab onto him, but look at the strength again. Just gets away from a couple of defenders. Here's Kapila, Fournaire, Theo Fournaire. Lovely ball out the back for Joseph. Jefferson Lee Joseph still going, and he'll get a try. It won't be enough for France, but Le Bleu finished with a flourish. And oh, how it could have been oh so different.
Oh, very much so. Joseph will get his double, but again, set up by the man DuPont. That was a beautiful pass from Fournier, and they're just showing his dexterity, his strength. Jefferson Lee Joseph.
Time back on.
One more act to this game is a successful conversion. It ends 2 points the difference, but you just feel that France might walk off this field thinking that's a massive, massive opportunity missed. The birthday boy, Cody Vai, got them started with the try scoring. He's pumped up for the gold medal match. New Zealand are through to the cup final. They will play Argentina. All Black Sevens' first chance of a gold medal this series.